This is my favorite opening of any opening. Just because I... Just with that music there.
Yeah. Dude, just your hair is so short. I mean, not as short as it is right now, but...
Yeah. It got really long.
Yeah, this is a pretty old movie.
Yeah, I mean, this is a...
Like, seriously.
I think it's April 2020.
Yeah, holy crap. Yeah, right when school shut down.
Right. So what happened this whole scene was supposed to be just this long take, like, following me through the school, like, right as school got out. But then, like, the week I was going to shoot it, school shut down. So then
I really do love this opening, too.
I did this one.
The music's awesome. This is one of my favorite movies.
Yeah, well, there's this quote by Martin Scorsese. He's talking about how, like, important credits are. And he's like, you shouldn't have, like, the credits just going, like, while people are driving. Like, that's just dumb and, like, it doesn't help the story and stuff. So I purposely did that because, you know, movies do that all the time. So I wanted it to be something, like, you weren't expecting, you know, everything that happens after this.
Okay.
Wanted it to start off pretty by the books.
Yeah. And then just turns into...
Just progressively.
I seriously love this movie for, like, so many reasons. CRV being one of them. I've seen you drive that car, like, one time.
Yeah. Well, it's gone now. We sold it.
We got the dumb truck.
No, we had the truck at this point.
I should say that. Now you drive the truck. A very wholesome family activity.
I know. Well, we actually did that. My dad was like, let's paint some stuff. And I was like, okay. Put it in the movie. That shirt got ruined. It has oil all over it.
Do you still wear it?
No. I wore it to construction after that. Or no, it got ink on it, and then I wore it when I was working construction, and it got, like, tons of dirt and oil all over it.
Dude, that's an aged shirt, then. Now you have to keep it.
Well, I still have it.
Good. You give it to your grandkid. What is the drawing there? What is that of?
That's a poster for the movie Alone, which is a really old one. See, what kind of happened... 2017, we did Files, and I think one after that. And then 2018, we just had, like, so many of these movies, and they weren't, like, very long or anything, but we just kept making them and making them. And then 2019, there was 3 movies, I think. So it went from there being, like, 18 of them to 3 of them. And there was just, like, nothing for so long.
Yeah.
And then... I made this one, and that kind of started off what I called the tall and short Renaissance period.
I thought it was Golden Age.
Yeah, well,
I feel like
you could call it that too.
Because you release so many movies, and then they
dropped
off.
And the most of them are some of our better ones. And
for real, now it's like 3 in the last 2 years or something.
I mean,
what year is Alone?
It's one of my movies.
Oh.
Yeah, no.
I'm like looking it up on Google.
I'll show you the picture after. That, I actually dug that hole. It was only about, like, to my chest.
Well, your unathletic 17-year-old body can't climb out of it.
Well, I'm trying to make it look deep.
Oh.
Yeah.
No, I understand.
I could climb, I could step out of it, dude.
The best is when you walk out of the room and then you're on the beach and the music just gets louder.
Cool story.
Shut up and look at that body.
Oh, yeah. Everyone's always like, ooh. Watching a skin flick here, Cash. That's what old people always say.
Watch a skin flick?
Yeah, they say, we're watching a skin flick here, Cash. Like, who?
What? Skin
a
flick?
Skin flick?
What the freak?
Like, it's a term I've never heard.
Yeah, Dude, you know what I
kind of... my belly right there.
You know what I kind of don't understand is, like, I love that. When, like, people frolic in the ocean. Yeah. Like, in Jaws, how much fun people have just, like, splashing in the water. Like, is it really that fun? Just, dude, like, sting your eyes and splash in the water?
There's this movie from, like, the late 70s with Harrison Ford. It's after Star Wars, but it's before he got, like, big, you know? It's with Gene Wilder. It's a cowboy movie, but there's this part where they just, like, make it to the ocean and just, like, the two of them just frolic like that. There's Adolf Hitler in the background.
Wait, like, young Frankenstein, Gene Wilder, and Harrison Ford? It's, like, the most random combination.
Oh, I know. What the heck? It's a really weird movie. And then it's like, the gayest scene ever, too. They're just, it's weird. It's a weird movie.
I really like your hair length in this scene, honestly.
Yeah, I do too.
Like,
it got
a week ago, it was too long. What the heck?
Well, I agree.
Is this why your dad thinks you've taken drugs before?
Yes. Not just this one.
There's like so many weird drug scenes.
There's a lot of kind of trippy things in my movies. I guess it's just kind of my style.
Where do you get them from?
I don't know, dude. Well, I mean, I was like. I don't know where most of the ideas for this came from.
Like, what's the puzzle piece in the apple? See, what the freak was, who was that? Who was that?
It's an old jazz musician, I can't remember who it is.
Like, when we were saying in freaking Aviator, you can't just, like, leave it hanging. You have to give people an answer.
The entire purpose of this movie is to, like, make you uncomfortable.
Like, what the freak was that? Here's dedication. Is the movie over now? No. It's got this weird clock, man. Screw this.
Yeah.
What is going on?
Well, the scene...
I love this movie until this point.
Really?
It's like I still like it, but now I'm like so confused and angry.
Yeah, that's the point.
I hate you.
So from this to the end of this kind of trip thing was actually supposed to be for... another movie. It was for Radcliffe 4, which we never even made the third one, but I wrote the entire script for both of them, and this was supposed to be in that, but then that movie got canceled, so I put it in this. Paul McCartney? Yep. Paul McCartney. Yeah.
I am incredibly impressed with which the, like,
George
editing.
Lucas.
Yeah, classic. Yeah, I'm incredibly impressed with the editing, and, like, how much you fit in here, and the concert that's going on.
Thank you. That's Brian Wilson from the Beach Boys. Oh, yeah. This was at a football game. It was someone, they were trying to do a kiss cam, but, like, the people wouldn't do it, so they was, like, trying to force them. You actually see Ethan's face right there.
I saw it. It was all a dream. Lazy.
Here's another thing.
Lazy story writing.
Thanks. Here's another thing. When I went to bed, the lights were off, and then when I wake up, they're on.
Well, it just looks like the sun's coming through the window.
Yeah.
I like your James Bond poster.
Thanks. I didn't make it.
Obviously. I figured. Well, dude, I was in this contest to, like, win a custom poster for No Time to Die, and he's like, it's down to two people, Will Woodward 5, my, like, Instagram name, and then, like, some other random guy from across the world. Uh-huh. And I was like, and then the other guy won, like, a week later. That's, I was so really dumb. Mad. I was pissed because it looked really, really cool.
And this I put, like, obviously I put that it's the end, but then I was like, I wonder how long I can have this go before people, like, turn it off, you know?
Yeah.
Because it just kind of goes on, and there's some whispering in the background of the scene, and it's just me reading the script. It's.
Are you able to hear it?
Yeah.
I mean, I can hear the whispering, but I can't really hear what you're saying.
No, you can't really hear what I'm saying, but yeah.
What is this music? What is this song? Who's that?
That's Peter Sellers, the actor. And this music is music that just kind of makes you uncomfortable, you know?
Mm-hmm.
The song's called Halloween. So it's like a super old classical song. And yeah. It's pretty horrible to the ears, you know?
Yeah.
which is the purpose.
The extent of which the violin screeches up and down in flat notes makes me really want to, you know, put a barrel in my mouth.
The part where it gets like super trippy and weird, I didn't say what the music is in that scene, but there's Frank Sinatra singing Jingle Bells, but it's like super slowed down, and then Be My Baby, the song Be My Baby, it's played backwards. I think that's all the music in there. Oh, and then the song Sunshine Superman by Donovan is like extremely slow.
Cool.
So yeah, it's a weird movie.
Yeah, it is.